see Miss Toots Opley raising her hand. Ma'am, it's Senator Marcos's time. I'll recognize the OFW groups because we called this meeting specifically to have the OFW side. But let's give the senators their time first. Oh, Senator Marcos.
Yes, don't worry. I will actually get to the OFW representative. Okay, pero balikan muna natin itong kung saan nagsimula lahat itong issue na ito. At itatanong ko lamang, Commissioner, sino mang nagutos na baguhin ang pulisiya ng Bureau of Customs na buksan? Imbis na kagaya ng dati, hindi na binubuksan ang mga balikbayan bus at kayo'y nagdeklara na ang bagong pulisiya ng Bureau of Customs ay bubuksan lahat ng balikbayan ba?
Nagsimula po yan nung kinausap po namin yung mga freight forwarders. Kasi nagre-review po ako eh. Na ang sabi ko sa kanila, ito ang nangyayari sa bayan.
Ang sinasabi nyo is that the freight forwarders were the ones who sila ang nakiusap sa iyo na pwede ba buksan ninyo lahat ng balikbayan ba?
Hindi po.
Sino ngayon ang nakaisip ng bagong polisiya na yun?
Kami po. Actually, that policy...
Kasi sino sa kami? Ikaw yun? Wala namang ganitong polisiya hanggat pumasok ka. Kaya ang iisipin namin lahat ay galing kay Commissioner Lina ito.
Opo, pero yung ginagawa na rin po nung araw yan.
Hindi talaga ginagawa nung araw yan. Kaya nga nagkagulo ng ganito. Kaya nga nagre-reklamo ang OFW. Dahil dati wala namang ganyan. Ba't ngayon nagkaroon? Anyway, kung yan ang naging bagong polisiya ninyo, saan nang galing yung bagong polisiya na yan? Ano naging dahilan kung bakit naisip ninyo na siguro dapat ngayon palitan natin ang dating gawi at gagawin natin ay bubuksan na ngayon natin lahat ng balikbayan ba?
Tama po kayo dyan. Sapagkat meron po mga derogatory reports also na ginagamit po yung ating quote-unquote balikbayan tungkol sa mga illegal drug at saka po
itong mga report ba ito, report lang, haka-haka lang ito, chismis ito, kwento lang sa inyo, o meron kayong investigation report na nakakapagsabi na nakahuli kami ng ilang balikbayan box na ang linalaman ay armas, ang linalaman ay droga, linalaman ay kontrabando. Meron ba kayong ganung sa palagay namin 30% ng lahat ng pumapasok na balikbayan box may problema o may ginagamit sa tamang paraan? Meron po ba kayong ganun?
Meron po.
Nasaan ngayon?
Ibibigay po namin sa inyo.
Ilan sa report na yan, ilan ang estimate ng mga investigador ninyo sa balikbayan box na merong ginagamit sa pag-smuggling o sa pagpasok nga ng mga kontraband? Ang hinahanap ko rito ay numero. Dahil para makita natin kung gaano kalala ang problema na na-identify ninyo.
Bibigyan po namin kayo ng report.
Wala ba kayo dyan? Siguro. Para maging maliwanag sa ating mga miyembro kung ano ba talaga ang how large is the problem? And was it so large that it justified triggering this change in policy? While you are looking for that, para tuloy-tuloy tayong usapan natin. Nung naisipin ninyo itong policy na ito, nakipag-ugnay ba kayo sa OWA, sa POEA, sa DFA, regarding, halimbawa, sa suggestion, iniisip namin, DFA, OWA, POEA, iniisip namin baguhin ang pulisiya ng Bureau of Customs, bubuksan kaya natin lahat ng mga account ng balikbayan box? Ano sa palagay ninyo? Meron ba kayong ganong klaseng konsultasyon?
Ang konsultasyon po ang ginawa namin through the freight forwarders. Nagpatawag po ako ng meeting na ganun po ang aming gagawin.
Pero hindi konsultasyon yun. You are informed, sabi mo, tinawag yung freight forwarders para mapaalam sa kanila na yun ang inyong gagawin. Ibig sabihin, you are just informing them. You're not consulting them.
Tama po kayo.
Oh, sige. So, did you have consultations? Meron kayong nakapag-meeting ka ba sa representative ng DFA, ng OWA, ng POEA, ng grupo ng mga OFW? sinabi nyo, kasi nagkakaproblema, may report kami rito, madaming problema, kailangan buksan na lahat ng mga balikbayan box, ano sa palagay ninyo. Meron ba kayong konsultasyon na gano'n?
Wala po.
Ah, wala?
Opo.
Ah, oh, sige. Okay. Ang naging simula nitong lahat ay yung inyong claim ay sinabi ninyo na ang problema nga ay ginagamit yung balikbayan box para mag-smuggle ng drugs at saka armas. Yun na nga, tinatanong ko sa iyo, ay ilan na nga ang Commissioner Overo was waving his hands earlier. Maybe we have those figures now.
Our Deputy Commissioner for Intelligence, Gerard okay. Dulosa, will
let us hear from him, please.
Good afternoon, Your Honor.
Good afternoon.
Actually, I have here record ng mga seizure ng Bureau of Customs covering 2014 up to 2015. Sa MICP alone, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, meron po doon na 7 containers ng apprehension. 7 containers.
7 containers?
Yes,
Your Honor. Anong linaman ng containers? Okay. Balikbayan box ba ito?
Actually, lahat po ng pumapasok doon sa MICP. Balikbayan box.
Okay.
Nakahalo po ito doon sa containers na may mga balikbayan box. I would like to give a example. Like for example, meron pong nahuling isang ATV, all-terrain vehicle, use. Uh-oh. Nakahalo po ito doon sa mga balikbayan boxes na nasa loob ng isang container.
Yes, yes, yes. Pero hindi. Yeah. Ang sinasabi mo yung pagbukas ng container. Ano hindi, ang tinatanong ko, kung ano yung ilan yung balikbayan box na may baril, na may shabu, na may okay. Contraband ng kahit na anong klase. Eh, siyempre, pagbukas mo ng container, yung ATV, paano mo itatago sa loob ng balikbayan box yun? Hindi na relevant yun.
Tama po.
Pinag-uusapan ko, yung ilan ang identified ninyo na kaso na ang linaman ng balikbayan box ay droga, armas. Dahil yan ang inyong, yan ang inyong statement eh. That balikbayan box are being used to smuggle drugs and firearms. How many cases do you have on record that a balikbayan box contained arms or drugs? Para simple.
I will be very specific, Your Honor. Actually, yes, sa intelligence group, we were able to apprehend only two. Dalawa lang po. Ito po yung mga...
Two balikbayan boxes?
Not actually two balikbayan boxes, pero isa po ang consignment nito.
Teka.
Yeah.
Let us limit our discussion to balikbayan box dahil yan ang usapan dito.
Tama po yun.
Okay.
Isang container.
Ilan ang balikbayan box na nahuli ninyo na ang linalaman ay armas o droga?
Hindi po armas.
O ano nga?
Isa commercial goods, commercial quantity.
Hindi yan ang ginawa ninyong dahilan kung bakit ninyo ginawa ito eh. Ang public pronouncement ninyo ay ginagamit ang mga balikbayan box upang magpasok ng armas at saka ng droga.
So,
kaya, dahil doon, kami ngayon sa Bureau of Customs ay bubuksan namin lahat ng balikbayan box. Okay. Sigurado naman ako na hindi nyo gagawin ito na walang dahilan. Ngayon, ang hinahanap ko sa inyo, ano yung dahilan na yun? How many balikbayan boxes have you opened that contain arms or drugs?
So far, you order negative sa balikbayan box.
Okay.
I would like to inform you, Your Honor,
so,
I could...
where did the information that balikbayan boxes are being used for arms and drugs come from?
Your Honor...
Kung wala kayong... you have none of your own experience.
Yung pong mga nahuli na mga drugs, ito po yung mga outbound shipment. Yung pong mga nahuli na regulated drugs...
Yan, okay, hindi na like, balikbayan boxes.
Like for example, mga ecstasy...
There is no balikbayan box going out of the Philippines. Balikbayan boxes only come into the Philippines, as far as I understand. Am I correct?
Okay. Tama po, Your Honor.
So, huwag na natin pag-usapan yung outbound. Hindi balikbayan box.
Sinasabi ko lang po.
Ang nais ko lang pag-usapan ngayon ay balikbayan box. Okay?
Okay,
I understand that your investigation ranges not only on balikbayan boxes.
Yes, tama
but
po.
The issue of the day is balikbayan boxes. So, let us focus on that. Okay. You have already stated that no balikbayan boxes have been found to contain arms or drugs. So far, meron ba? Baka meron man, maraming nakalusot. Pero so far, wala naman kayo nahuhuli.
So far po, sa record namin, wala. Kung balikbayan ang pag-uusapan.
Yun talaga, yan lang ang ating pag-uusapan.
Yes,
okay.
Or no?
Now, Saan ngayon nagkaroon na, well, maybe I should turn to the commissioner. Commissioner, what was the basis of your statement that Balikbayan boxes are being used to smuggle arms and drugs? If there was no such incident recorded by your own investigative arm.
Now, I sat in only as your commissioner in the last 3 months, where there are some reports that I received that it will gonna be used for the smuggling of drugs.
Okay. Actually, where did those reports?
Some of those reports are coming in from different calls. But as a matter of fact, we did have some.
Your investigative officer.
Intelligence who ba yon? Intelligence commissioner.
Some received calls from you know. Outside calls.
You know, if I was a competitor of somebody, I will say that my competitor is smuggling drugs and guns. Eh, para kuluhin ko lang yung buhay niya. But that doesn't mean that it's true. Just a call, just a letter, that doesn't mean a thing. You have to investigate
that's why, Mr. Senator, at least
to yourself, if nobody else, that this is what is happening, to find out the truth.
No, yes. we have the reports here. If you want, we will submit to you.
Who are they from? Where do those reports originate from? From the AFP, from ISAP, from the police intelligence, PNP intel. Where do these intelligence reports come from? Sa inyo lang, internal?
Well, we receive also reports from.
It's a very nice picture and a very nice slide. But where did this come from?
Well, sir, actual ho yung ibang huli na yan sa airports.
Yes, okay, fine. Pero we're talking about Balikbayan boxes. There is no apparently. Yes, I'll get to you. There is no record of Deputy Commissioner De Jose just said there is negative. Huli. Na Balikbayan box na may laman na armas o droga. Yan naman ang statement niya. I'm just taking it from your statement. Where did this information spring from? Where did it come from?
Sir, actually yan.
Kaya from whom?
That is our apprehension.
But these are Balikbayan boxes? Tingnan mo.
That is coming from our enforcement group, Mr. Senator. We have a copy here of our apprehension.
Yeah, but all of these, sir, tignan mo. One unit used Honda motorcycle. One unit Harley Davidson motorcycle. One unit motorcycle. Hindi magkasya sa Balikbayan bag sa motorsiklo.
Boss, parts po yan eh.
Motorcycle.
Malaki-laki yung box yun.
Boss, nakahalo yan sa Balikbayan.
I think si Commissioner De Liosa, former Commissioner Biaton.
Well, I'm going to this.
Can we ask them
to? Yes, please.
Is it okay?
Please,
Marshall,
yeah. Let me give you a chance.
Si Devcom De Liosa and then former Commissioner Biaton. And then, what's your name, ma'am? Attorney Mangawang, you're after.
Right, Your Honor, actually yung pong nahuling baril sa parcel po ito.
Kaya nga.
Parcel. It's
kaya
not a Balikbayan box.
That's fair enough. That's okay. Yeah. Naintindihan ko yan. Pero ang pinag-uusapan nito ay Balikbayan.
Yes,
box.
You're right, Your
Honor. Okay, so let us stay focused on the subject at hand. What we are talking about is why did you institute the new policy of wanting to open all the Balikbayan boxes? Commissioner Lina, you just told me that it was your initiative. I am now asking what was the basis of that change in policy. Apparently, we have no record of any Balikbayan boxes actually being found to contain arms and drugs, as you publicly declared.
Can I ask?
You identify the problem as being the problem that you said you have identified is that Balikbayan box are used to smuggle drugs and arms. Now we find out that your intelligence department has no record of any Balik Bayan box ever containing drugs or arms. Now, then I do not understand why you decided to undertake this policy. And I think at this point, since at least we have found already that the Balik Bayan boxes are not, in fact, being used to smuggle drugs and arms, or if so, it is a small fraction of the other drugs and arms that are being smuggled through packages, through containers, and other contraband. Kaya isama na natin yung mga motorsiklo, yung mga meron pa dito, jet ski. Magkaling masyado yung pinagkasa yung jet ski doon sa loob ng Balik Bayan. Anyway, my point is, I am happy that you have retracted this policy. All that is left, I think, when are you going to apologize to our OFWs? When are you going to admit to your mistake? When are you going to realize that this is parang hindi na Pilipino ang galaw na ito eh. This is being unkind to the people that are keeping our economy alive. You know, they remit 25 billion. That is already, there are fees taken from the $25 billion by the government. Then now, these small gestures of affection and remembrance, you are now going to cause problems with that. And it turns out there is no basis. There have been no, let me repeat it, and I was expecting that you will give me some numbers. But apparently, it's even less than I thought. It is zero. Zero Balik Bayan boxes have ever been found to contain arms or drugs. And so, this was, it feels arbitrary. And because of that arbitrary change in policy, I think what is in order is that the Bureau of Customs and you, Commissioner Lina, just issue an apology. Admit that you were wrong. Tell the OFWs, we care for you. We value you. We are not trying to harass you. We are not accusing you of being smugglers. We were trying to do our job, but we went down the wrong path. I am sorry. Madali lang naman yan eh. And I think it will be much appreciated by our OFWs. Now, I would ask who would like to speak as an OFW rep.
Chairman, can I interject?
Yes, please, of course.
I just want to add na this is the second time. The first time was when they asked the Balik Bayan to pay the 550 travel tax kahit na exempted sila.
Ayan, iba pa yun.
And then nagmatigas din yung
MIA.
Oo, nagmatigas din
si Bureau of Customs. If I'm not mistaken, that's
General Honrado.
Oh, it's the airport.
Hindi nila babawiin yun. Hindi nila binawi yun. Hanggang ngayon, nasa court case pa din yun. At pina-inhibit pa nila yung judge para wag madesisyonan yun. So hanggang ngayon, nagbabayad yung mga balikbayan ng 550. Kahit sa law, exempted sila. So that is the first time. And this is the second time. Parang merong sunod-sunod silang tama sa atin eh. Sana wag naman. Kasi pag i-interviewin tayo, they are our modern-day heroes. Tapos sila yung tama ng tama sa ating mga policy. So, siguro, it's time that we really work hard na bawiin to lahat kasi nakakahiya.
That's a good point, Senator Villar. And we will assure the OFWs that they'll have their time to speak in the committee.
Absolutely.
And after Senator Marcos and Senator...
No, Mr. Chairman, I was going to turn right now to the OFWs.
Well, let's have an orderly procedure.
No, sir,
if you would finish with your questions, Senator Marcos, then recognize them one by one. Go ahead, sir.
Yes. Who would like to speak as the representative of the OFWs? I'm sorry, I cannot see your...
I'm Connie Ricalado of Migrante.
Oh, all right. Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
That's right.
Gusto ko lang pong i-reiterate yung demands.
Before we get to that, I just have a couple, just very quick, simple questions for you. What is the penalty for drugs and firearms use for smuggling purposes in the Middle East, for example?
I don't have any idea.
Any of the others?
Yes.
Sir, we actually have an OFW vacationing from Saudi Arabia here.
Oh, yeah.
So, si Jong Linesa po.
Are you, anong pangalan mo, Balyesa?
Mel Linesa po. Mel Linesa.
Linesa, okay. Now, I will ask you, very simple. Anong penalty sa Saudi Arabia pagka may nahulihan ka ng armas o ng droga? Na halimbawa, sinusubukan mong ilagay sa balikbayan box para ipadala sa Maynila?
Actually po, sa Saudi Arabia is napakahigpit po talaga. At ang terrorist po ang ano.
Ang dating mo, anong gagawin sa'yo?
Death penalty po yung pugot ulo
po. Penalty yun. Kaya opo. Siguro naman walang sira ulong Pilipino. Magkikipagano
din sa po.
ganyang klaseng operation. Meron ba kayong natatanggap na guideline sa balikbayan box na sinasabi, hindi ba meron kayong pre-departure orientation seminar ni OFW?
Opo, meron po.
Okay, ipinapaliwanag ba doon na ito ang polisiya ng Bureau of Customs na kailangan ganito, kailangan ganyan ang gawin ninyo?
Tama po, tama po. Lahat meron po ng mga pagbabawal ay binibigay po sa amin, pinapaalam sa amin, at sa 20 years ko po na OFW, wala naman pong nangyari na nagkaroon ng incidente na nagkaroon ng ganong kaso.
Ikaw ba'y nandito para magbakasyon o opo, umuwi ka na ng permanente?
Ako po'y nakabakasyon na okay. August 1st po. By September 15, balik po ako.
Actually, para makatulong din tayo dun sa diskusyon ni Senator Rec tungkol sa balon ng mga gamit. Kung ikaw, for whatever reason, napilitan kang umuwi ngayon, magkano ang balor ng mga gamit na naipon mo na nandun kung saan ka na tinirahan sa Saudi Arabia, sasabihin mo, eto pagbibigay ko na, eto ipagbibili ko, pero eto iuwi ko. Yung mga gamit na yan, ano sa palagay mo ang value niya?
Okay po. Sa pag-uwi ko po ito, gumastos po ako ng almost na mga 30 to 50,000. Pasalubong lang po sa aking pamilya.
50,000 pesos. 30 to 50,000 pesos.
Opo.
Ano yung mga bagay-bagay na yan?
Yung po ay yung mga sabon, pabango. Hindi po, wala pong mga gadgets dito. Kasi
wala,
po.
Wala man electronics.
Wala po.
Television,
wala po.
CD player.
Wala po.
iPad, walang ganon.
Wala pong ganon.
Oh, sige. Parang typical naman yun, hindi ba? Sa 20 taon mo, marami ka nang nakita balikbayan. Halos pare-pareho lang naman ang mga inuwi. Shampoo, laruan.
Po, tama po.
Sneakers, ang madalas. Ang bago, wala pa sa Pilipinas.
Opo.
Oh, yan ang mga nakikita natin sa pagbalikbayan. Yes, I'm sorry, I cannot go.
Yan po.
Please identify yourself and which organization you represent, and maybe tell us a little bit about your organization, how many members, etc. Anong countries?
Magandang hapon po, honorable senators. Ako po si Jan Bertis, ang spokesperson po ng OFW Advocates Coalition, consisting of 20 different migrant groups worldwide, kasama rin po ang CSO rito. So, ang sa akin
ano
na
po yung CSO? What is CSO?
Civil Society Organization po. Tulad po
anong,
ng Office Center.
Anong bilang po ng inyong grupo?
Sorry.
Ano po yung bilang ng inyong membership po?
Ang PEBA po, which is the our arms in abroad, overseas, meron po kaming members na 300,000 and 60 administrators. And ang Office Center din po, ganun din po ang LBS at iba pa pang grupo ng aming coalition sa meron din po mga United Seafarers, nandito rin po ang Kampi, andyan din po ang FEDAMINEX, which is the Federation of Service Exporters. Ito rin po ang mga nakipaglaban doon sa amin terminal
people. Yes, go ahead. Oh.
All right, please go ahead. And, you wanted to say something.
Yung pahawak niyo po, dear senators, na mga pictures, actually nakita po namin sa presentation ng BOC on last Monday during the walkthrough. Tinutulan ko nga po yun kasi yung mga litrato po na pinipresent nila na binibintang bilang balikbayan boxes ay hindi naman po talaga mga balikbayan boxes. Kasi ang aming mga boxes po, lahat po ng side ng aming balikbayan boxes may pangalan ng aming pamilya. At ganun din po, nagbibigay po kami ng tulad po sa Saudi Arabia nung nandun po ako. Bago kami makapagpadala, hinihingi po yung kopya ng aming President's ID. So paano po ibibintang sa amin yung mga drugs at barrel na yan?
Oo nga. Kaya nga, eh, kahit naman ang custom sinasabi, hindi naman sa nasa palikbayan box, kaya nakakapagtaka kung bakit umabot nga sa ganito. Anyway, Miss Ople, you wanted to add something?
Yes, sir. Doon lang po sa punto ng public apology, bakit po ba ito mahalaga sa mga OFWs? Kasi po very public po yung campaign ng ginawa ng BOC at napanood po talaga worldwide. So pag hindi po na-correct yung impression na yon, meron po tayong mga foreign employers tsaka mga host governments. Mahirap naman po kung nakabitin lang yon na lumalabas naman ngayon at nagpapasalamat kami sa Senado. Hindi kasi namin alam yung sa sektor namin na merong dinagdag na singilin na pwedeng ipasa sa OFW. Hindi rin po namin alam kung bakit yung intelligence records pala ng BOC, zero yung alam namin na imposibleng may OFW na i-risk yung kontrata niya para magpadala ng drugs na ang sender and nakalagay yung address ng kanyang pamilya. Alam po na, I mean, common sense na lang yun. Ngayon, ang hinihingi na lang po namin, public apology and then policy coherence and clarity dahil po naghahanda na po magpadala ng pampasko yung ating mga OFWs. Lagi po sinasabi, kailangan ipatupad yung batas. Eh, obvious naman po na hindi na relevant yung batas ngayon. Ipapatupad pa po ba yun? And, kumbaga, parang may sword of Damocles sa bawat OFW ngayon. Hindi nila alam saan sila lulugan. Ang gusto lang naman nila, mapasaya yung kanilang mga pamilya.
Well, okay, so baliwanag na hindi lamang dahil sa sama ng loob at kampo ng ating mga OFW, mahalagang apology. But even their hireability, dahil sasabihin ng mga masisira ang reputasyon ng Filipino workers kung ang gobyerno natin mismo ang nagsasabi, ang mga OFW na yan, mga smuggler ng droga at saka armas. Eh, sino nga naman ang gustong maging employer ang isang smuggler ng droga at armas? Kaya I think that is an added dimension as to why that apology is very important. And I will end there, Mr. Chairman, and merely to reiterate that there is a need for that apology, at least as public an apology as the declaration of this new policy, and something that will be our workers can show to their employees it's not true. That was a mistake, and that was an anomaly in the policy of our government. They trust us, they think highly of us, and so should you. And that is not a small thing when you are trying to find work abroad and you are trying to be an OFW. So, ididiin ko yun, Chairman, Commissioner, ididiin ko, kumari lang, at kung ano yung publicity na nakuha nitong back change yung policy, paliwanag ninyo. Hindi, binago namin, hindi na namin bubuksan. At wala kaming hinala na ang ating mga OFW ay naging smuggler ng armas o naging smuggler ng droga. And I think that will go a long, long, long way to giving them peace of mind, giving their employers peace of mind. And maybe, Commissioner, you will finally find some peace of mind also in your new job. But in any case, I will end there, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.